फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू माय चैनल प्लांट्स एंड बर्ड्स। इन लास्ट वीडियो एज वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मिनरल न्यूट्रिशन इन हॉर्टिकल्चर, इन टुडेस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मैक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स इन डिटेल्ड, अबाउट इट्स फिजियोलॉजिकल फंक्शंस एंड न्यूट्रिशनल डेफिशिएंसीज इन डिटेल्ड मैनर। फर्स्टली वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नाइट्रोजन, ए प्राइमरी न्यूट्रिएंट। Okay, macronutrients are classified as primary and secondary. The primary nutrients are NPK, nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Okay, in that first one is nitrogen. Nitrogen is the first primary nutrient. Soil is the chief sources. What are the sources we will going to know? Okay, soil is the chief source of nitrogen. Plants absorb nitrogen either in the form of nitrate, that is NO3- or ammonical salts, NH4. NH4 plus, ammonical salts. Some bacteria and heterocysts containing blue-green algae fix nitrogen of atmosphere. Okay, blue-green algae is especially for to fix the nitrogen in the soil, atmosphere, fix nitrogen of atmosphere. Okay, which can be utilized by the plants. Okay, now we will know the physiological rules in detail. Present in the structure of protein molecule. Okay, first nitrogen is present in the structure of protein molecule. It is found in important molecules like purine, pyrimidines, which are essential in protein synthesis. Purines and pyrimidines, which are essential in protein synthesis, etc. It is also found in porphyrins ring, found in chlorophyll and cytochrome enzymes, and hence it is essential for photosynthesis. Okay, it is participated in the coenzyme, essential for the function of many enzymes. Coenzymes are essential for function of many enzymes. It is readily mobile within the plant tissue. So when its deficiency occurs, it is transformed from older leaves to younger leaves. So its deficiency disorder is seen in older leaves itself, where it is reutilized. Okay. Next, what are the some specific deficiencies are given here? That are, plant growth is stunted and poorly developed because protein content, cell division, cell enlargement are decreased. Okay, nitrogen deficiency causes yellowing, that is chlorosis, loss of chlorophyll of leaves. Protein and starch contents are decreased. Prolonged dormancy, that is state of inactive, in all the plant parts undergo into inactive state of growth. Okay, that is known as dormancy, and early senescence appears. Veins turn purple and red due to development of abundant anthocyanin pigment. Okay, this purple color is developed on the leaves due to the anthocyanin pigment. An example in tomato and in apple, it will commonly occurs. Okay, the angle between the stem and the leaves is reduced. Okay, so that the photosynthesis cannot take place in a correct manner. Okay, plants to look so sickly and conspicuous pale, that is the condition is called general starvation. Okay, plants look so sickly, okay, like it is affected by a disease like that, and conspicuous pale, okay, there is no growth in the plant. Okay, that condition is called as general starvation. Okay, symptoms first occur on older leaves due to its mobility. Okay, what are the corrective measures? Fertilizers like ammonium sulfate, calcium nitrate, urea, and one of the important fertilizer is used is CAN, that is calcium ammonium nitrate, which is also a important fertilizer to improve the soil structure. Okay, calcium ammonium nitrate. Okay, next, foliar spray of 1-2% of urea is a quick method of ameliorating nitrogen deficiency. Okay, spraying of 1-2% of urea. Okay, next, these are some, what happened if it is excess or it is a deficiency. On your right hand side, it is a deficiency, some of the deficiency disorders, as we all discussed all this. But excess, what happened if it is given in excess amount? Stem becomes weak due to high growth, heavy growth it occurs. Foliage become weak due to high foliage. There is no complete protein, there is no sufficient protein, not sufficient for each and every leaf. Okay, greenness moves up. Okay, full greenness will come. Okay, bottom leaves turn lush dark green. Okay, botanist full dark green it will be turned. Ke water fluid transport system becomes weak. Ke harvest tasters green. Fully green will be. Ke excess vegetative growth occurs. Due to this, less vegetative growth is. Reproductive growth is a result of this excess of nitrogen. Causes yield loss also. Okay, these are some deficiencies in tomato, potato, soybean. Okay, these are some. See, we can identify in soybean easily that yellowing of leaves. Next, in cotton, groundnut, sunflower. Okay, we will see. We can easily identify that it is a nitrogen deficiency. Lower leaves become yellowish. Sugarcane, Bengal gram, maize. These are the deficiencies in this occur mainly in these crops: cotton, groundnut, sunflower, Bengal gram, maize, and sugarcane. Agriculture crops. Okay, see, we can differentiate healthy leaf, nitrogen overdose, nitrogen deficient. Okay, nitrogen overdose leaf is heavily green in nature. Okay, dark green in nature when nitrogen deficient is in yellowish due to loss of chlorophyll. Okay, next primary nutrient is phosphorus, NPK, no? In that phosphorus. Okay, source: the plant absorbs phosphorus in the form of soluble phosphate such as phosphoric acid, that is H3PO4, and hydrogen phosphate, HPO4. The absorption ability differs from plant to plant. Cabbage and alfalfa can absorb phosphate from rocks, whereas barley, corn, oats cannot absorb so efficiently. Okay, cabbage and alfalfa absorb phosphate from rocks itself. Okay, whereas barley, corn, and oats cannot absorb so efficiently. Okay, now physiological roles. It is found abundantly in the growing and storage organs such as fruits, seeds. Okay. Okay, which is abundantly found, okay, in growing and storage organs like fruits and seeds. Okay, it promotes healthy root development and fruit ripening through the translocation of carbohydrates. Okay, this is important function of the phosphorus is fruit ripening. Okay, and healthy root development. These are the two important functions as I told in the last video. Okay. Next, it is essential element participating in the skeleton of plasma membrane, nucleic acid, organic molecules such as ATP. Adenosine triphosphate, in that phosphorus is present, and other phosphorylated compounds. It also found in plants as a constituent of nucleic acid, phospholipids, or coenzymes like NAD. Okay, next, phospholipids along with protein may be transported in cell membrane. Okay, it is readily mobile within the plant. These are the some specific deficiencies. Okay, of phosphorus. Young leaves remain stunted and with dark blue green. And sometimes purplish leaves are developed. Phosphorus may cause premature leaf fall. Okay, dead necrotic, that is dead of tissues, areas are developed on leaves and fruits. Okay, leaves sometimes develop anthocyanin in winds, may become necrotic. Leaves will be in dark green in color. Okay, leaves will become dark green and anthocyanin can develop, that is purple pigment, and which leads to may become necrotic, that is death of tissues. Okay, cambial cavity is checked. Okay, that is movement of water and food is checked. There is no movement. Tillering of crops is reduced. Okay, dormancy is prolonged. Okay, here dormancy is means a state of in a specific plant part is undergo dormancy, then it is there is no growth and development in that part. Growth is retarded. Sickle leaf disease is caused by phosphorus deficiency, which is characterized by chlorosis adjacent to main vein, followed by leaf asymmetry. Okay, this is sickle leaf disease. Important to be noted, this sickle leaf disease. Okay, tillering in crop means which spreading of the crop is reduced, which is characterized by chlorosis adjacent to main veins, followed by leaf asymmetry. Okay, sickle leaf disease. Next, what are the corrective measures? Okay, spraying 2% of DAP or application of phosphatic fertilizers. Okay, are the important corrective measures. Spraying of 2% of DAP or application of phosphatic fertilizers are the corrective measures. This important is tillering of crops is reduced, dormancy is prolonged, and premature leaf fall. Okay, necrosis is due to phosphorus. Necrosis. Okay, corrective leaf disease is an important disorder of phosphorus deficiency. Next, excess of phosphorus causes new leaves grown with thin blades. Okay. Newly leaves develops intervenal chlorosis, that is loss. New leaves losses chlorophyll. Okay. Leaf tips and margin burn. Okay. Tips will be burned. Less internodal space. Okay. Space between two nodes is called internode. Less internodal dimension harvest. Okay. Zinc and iron micronutrient deficiencies. High phosphorus causes zinc and iron deficiencies. This is important to be mind. Calcium and magnesium deficiencies, of course. Calcium, magnesium, zinc, iron, all this will be low if you give excess of phosphorus. Okay. Lower leaves curl, develop spots. Curling of lower leaves occurs. Dry buds have a chemical taste. Okay. Buds are dry, which have chemical taste. Okay. Root tips die back. Root tips will be die from tip to the upper side, upper, okay, to the end. Okay, these are the toxic symptoms of phosphorus. Important are less internodal space, okay, interminal chlorosis in upper leaves, leaf tips burn, margins burn, zinc, iron, calcium, magnesium deficiencies occur, okay. Root tips dieback is important. Okay. Lower leaves curl. Dry buds have chemical taste. It is not important that much. Root tips dieback and zinc, iron, calcium, magnesium. Calcium, magnesium, zinc, iron. These are the four elements undergo deficiency. If you give in, if plant occurs, plant undergo phosphorus toxicity. Okay. Next. These are symptoms of sugar beet, Brussels, rape plant, gooseberry shoot, okay, maize plant. See, we can see upper leaves are turned into the purplish, that is anthocyanin pigment is developed, which undergo necrosis, that is death of the tissues. Apple leaves also, see, cotton, okay, paddy shows the, okay, phosphorus deficiency. In paddy you can see that there is a upper leaves turned into the yellowish and or purplish color due to and development of anthocyanin. Maize, Bengal gram, sunflower, okay, sugar cane, red gram, all turn their upper leaves into the, in upper leaves there is a main symptom is development of anthocyanin pigment on upper leaves, that is younger leaves, which causes necrosis. Okay, short internode, okay, in cotton, sunflower, red gram, you can see the short internode, Bengal gram. Okay, next. Potassium, third primary nutrient is potassium. Potassium is widely distributed in soil. Forms such as potash, feldspar, mica, gluconite are slowly converted into soluble forms by weathering process. It is strongly fixed in soil largely as an exchangeable base. The potassium is found in less available form. Small amount of normally present in the soil in the exchangeable form. What are the physiological roles? It is concerned with formation of carbohydrate and protein synthesis, photosynthesis, transpiration regulation, enzyme action, photosynthesis of nucleic acid, chlorophyll, oxidation and photophosphorylation, translocation of solutes. These are the main functions of potassium. Okay. It is actively involved in opening and closing of stomata. Which macronutrient is involved in opening and closing of stomata is potassium. This is important to be noted. It takes an important role in drought tolerance of, okay, through water relations. It offers resistance to pests and diseases. Okay, it offers a important point. Next important point, it offers a resistance to abiotic and biotic stresses. Biotic and abiotic stresses. It is present in the soluble form, mostly contained in the cells upon cytoplasm. It is readily mobile within the plant tissue. Okay. What are the three important, okay, physiological roles are, okay, first one is opening and closing of stomata, involved in opening and closing of stomata. Next one is, next is, next is, that is, tolerance to biotic and abiotic stresses. And next, third one is, okay, it is readily mobile in the plant. Okay, these are three important physiological roles of potassium. Next, deficiency symptoms. Mild deficiency causes thin shoots may develop and which there may be a restricted shoot growth. Acute deficiency causes shoot may die back. Dieback disease means from shoot onwards it will go on dying towards the tip, where end of the stem. Okay, shoot to end of the stem, dieback. This is important deficiency disorder of potassium. Leaf will be dull and bluish green in color. Chlorosis occurs in intervenal region. Intervenal chlorosis means loss of chlorophyll in intervenal region. In older is browning of tips. Okay, browning of tips, marginal scorching, leaf scorch means that is loss of full chlorophyll and turning into a dark spots are appeared. So developed of brown spots near the margin occurs. Necrotic areas developed at the tip at the margins of the leaves which curve downward. Downward curling is seen, and where important to be noted is tips, tip and margins will turn necrotic, they undergo death. This where tip and margin tissues undergoes death. In broad-leaved plants, shortening of internodes and poor root system are important. Okay, in broad-leaved plants. Okay, corrective measures are supply of muriate of potash or foliar spray of 1% potassium chloride is commonly used to overcome potassium deficiency. Okay, next, sulfate of potash, which contains 18% of sulfate, which is very helpful for the plant growth. Okay, next, potassium. If potassium is given in excess, what are the effects it causes? Okay, soil pH is important. Toxicity of potassium is pH of the soil is undergoes less, that is alkalinity and salinity occurs. Alkalinity occurs. Okay, alkali soil turns into alkali soils, neutral to alkali. Okay, new leaves grown tip blades. Okay, newer leaves develop intervenal chlorosis, leaf tips and margins burn. Okay, less internodal space cause calcium, magnesium, zinc, iron. As told in a phosphorus, CM will occur in the if excess of potassium is given. Lower leaves curl, develop spots, root zone is acidified. See, pH lowers. Sorry, when pH is gone down, then pH scale is 0 to 14, where 6 to 7 is a neutral pH. And when the pH is get decreases, that is below 6 or okay, below 6 means it is acidic, when above 7 is alkalic. Okay, where they told potassium decreases, excess of potassium decreases pH, decrease in pH means 6 to below. Okay, which causes acidification of root zone. Okay, root tips is dieback. This is potassium deficient leaf. See, in tips, the loss of chlorophyll is seen and brown spot is developed. Okay, in cotton, we can see the margins where necrotic and margins where become chlorosis, loss of chlorophyll, and they lead to necrosis. Okay, chlorosis and necrosis both occur in potassium deficiency. Okay, maize, sugarcane, sunflower, all margins can become necrotic, tissues were died. Okay, cells were dyed along the margins, groundnut, maize, Bengal gram, okay, cotton, same, okay, this is red gram, not cotton. Next, tomato. In tomato, see, you can see cauliflower plants at cutting time, okay, sugar beet or potato, all these are the potassium deficiencies. Okay, onion, barley, maize, apple leaves, gooseberry leaves, bean shoot. Okay, see, onion, now it is turned. Next. Okay, NPK in definition, in easy way to be remembered is, the leaf maker is, okay, nitrogen. कि नाइट्रोजन इज नोन एज अ लीफ मेकर, कि प्रोड्यूसिंग ए न्यू सेल्स एंड एंजाइम्स, प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ग्रीन पिगमेंट्स दैट इज क्लोरोफिल, रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर लीफ एंड स्टेम ग्रोथ, हेल्प्स प्लांट विथ रैपिड ग्रोथ दैट इज वेजिटेटिव ग्रोथ. ओके नेक्स्ट, द फ्लेवर इंड्यूसर और फूड मेकर इज ए पोटेशियम. फ्लेवर इंड्यूसर और फूड मेकर इज पोटेशियम. दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी माइंड. ओके, कि एंकरेज अपटेक ऑफ वाटर, essential in the development of flowers and fruits, increase plant resistance to diseases, helps plant maker better use of light and air. Okay, next, phosphorus. This is a root maker. Phosphorus is known as a root maker or flower inducer. Okay, encourage root growth and blossoming, essential part of process of photosynthesis, involved in the formation of all oils, sugars and starches in the plant. Okay, these are important to be noted. Next, magnesium. These are the secondary nutrients. Now we will discuss about the secondary nutrients: magnesium, calcium, sulfur. These three. Okay, magnesium occurs as carbohydrate held in soils as an exchangeable base. It is easily leached, and for the reason may become deficient in sandy soils during wet periods. Okay, heavy application of potassium reduces its absorption. As I told, potassium is a main first. Okay, when heavy application of potassium is done, then it leads to the deficiency of magnesium. Okay, what is the physiological roles of magnesium? Constituent of chlorophyll, therefore essential for photosynthesis. This is important role of magnesium. Acts as a phosphorus carrier in the, it carries phosphorus. Okay, phosphorus carrier in the plant. It is essential for synthesis of fats and metabolism of carbohydrates. It is acts as an activator for many enzymes in phosphate transfer reactions in carbohydrate metabolism and nucleic acid synthesis. It is involved in the formation of seed of high oil content containing a compound called lecithin, which is important point to be remembered. Involved in the formation of seeds of high oil content, that is oils, that is sunflower and next, okay, sunflower oil seeds. What are the oil seeds we consume? Sunflower, groundnut. In all this, they will, this magnesium application will increase the formation of high oil content with the containing a compound called lecithin. Okay, it is readily mobile within the plant tissues. Next, what are the deficiency symptoms? Cause intravenous chlorosis. Okay, the older leaves are affected first and they proceed systematically towards the younger leaves. Dead necrotic spots appear on the leaves. Means, there is a spots on the leaves which where the tissues are dead. Okay, necrotic spots are the leaves. Severely affected leaves may weather and shed or abscess without the weathering stage. Okay, defoliation is quite severe. Okay, keratin content is reduced. Okay, keratin content means color of the fruits and vegetables is reduced. Okay, stem becomes yellowish green. Okay, yellowish green, often hard and woody. Okay, corrective measure, spray of 2% of magnesium sulfate MgSO4. Spray of 2%. Important are keratin content is reduced. Stem become hard and woody with yellowish green color. Okay, dead necrotic spots on the leaf are the important symptoms of magnesium. Okay, next, see in cotton we can see the dead anthocyanin pigment is developed, which leads to death of dead necrotic spots is seen. In paddy also, lower part green and upper part will turn into the yellowish color. Okay, in sugarcane, maize, you can see the necrotic spots, and sunflower where chlorotic spots are seen. See red gram. These are the magnesium deficiency symptoms. Okay, in barley, cabbage and grapes. See, this is magnesium deficiency in grapes. Next, sulfur. It is available to plants in the form of soluble phosphates of soil. Okay, it is important constituent of the physiological vibrancy. Okay, it is available in the form of soluble sulfates of soil. It is an important constituent of some amino acids, cysteine, सिस्टीन एंड मिथियोनाइन, विटामिन्स बायोटिन थायमिन, कोएंजाइम ए एंड वोलेटाइल ऑयल्स. ओके इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी नोटेड दिस विटामिन इन विटामिन्स बायोटिन दैट इज B7 ओके एंड थायमिन ओके इट कंटेन सल्फर बायोटिन एंड थायमिन सिस्टीन ओके सिस्टीन सिस्टाइन एंड मिथियोनाइन कंटेन सल्फर. ओके नेक्स्ट इट इज पार्टिसिपेटेड इन फोटोसिंथेसिस सल्फोहाइड्रिल ग्रुप्स आर नेसेसरी फॉर द एक्टिविटी ऑफ मेनी एंजाइम. डाइसल्फाइड लिंक्स हेल्प्स इन स्टेबलाइज द प्रोटीन स्ट्रक्चर. दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी नो. कैरेटिक ऑर्डर ऑफ क्रूसिफेरस प्लांट्स ऑनियन एंड गार्लिक एज ए कैरेटिक ऑर्डर सी व्हेन वी कट देम दिस इज ड्यू टू द सल्फर एज अ कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ वोलेटाइल ऑयल्स. इट इज इमोबाइल इन द प्लांट टिश्यू. When it is deficiency occurs, it is not transported to the younger leaves but accumulated in the older leaves only. As it recurs, as a result, deficiency symptoms develop on first on younger leaves. Okay, sulfur is known as a yield plus nutrient. This is important to be noted because it improves the yield and quality of the food crops. Okay. Next, sulfur deficiency. Okay, what are the deficiency disorders? Causes yellowing, that is sclerosis of the leaves, is the first one. Tip and margins of roll inward. Inward rolling is occurs. Okay. Mark a decrease in the okay and phosphorus downward. Okay. Rolling era inward. Upward rolling is occurs. Okay. Mark a decrease in leaf size. General paling with red or purple pigmentation. That is anthocyanin pigmentation is also occur. Necrosis of ganglios. Okay. Death of ganglios occurs. Tips. Okay. Ganglios leaf tips will undergo death. Internodes are shortened, apical growth is inhibited and lateral buds develop prematurely. Apical growth is inhibited and lateral buds develop. Apical growth is inhibited and lateral buds develops prematurely. Young leaves develop orange, red or purple pigments. Leaf tips are characterized bent downwards. The leaf margins and tips roll inward. Okay. Inward rolling, tomato, tobacco, tea can be seen in mainly. Okay, fruit formation is suppressed. Okay, sclerenchyma, xylem, colenchyma formation get increased and hence the stem becomes unusually thick due to sulfur deficiency. Okay, fruit formation is suppressed. It's important deficiency of sulfur. in case of severe deficiency, gypsum is added to the soil at 500 kg per hectare. 2.5 hectare is equal to 2.5 acre. Okay, gypsum is added to the soil at 500 kg per hectare. Next, this is a deficiency disorders. Deficiency in cotton, paddy. You can see the pale yellow color in the younger leaves. Okay, yellowing of pale white color. Okay, like nitrogen in older leaves. Here, sulfur in younger leaves. Maize sulfur. Bengal gram. Okay. Tomato sulfur deficient. Okay. Sulfur deficient tomato plant can be seen. Okay. Sugar cane. Sulfur deficient tea. See upper leaves turn into pale yellowish color. Okay. Tips will be necrotic. Upper leaves. Next. This is in grapes. See. In younger leaves, tips will be get necrotic, that is dead of tissues occur. Next is element is calcium. Okay, this is third secondary element, last secondary element. Calcium occurs in soil with variety of minerals. The soil derived from the stone or chalk rocks contain larger percentage of carbonates of lime, calcium carbonate. Okay, well, sandy soils show calcium deficiency when it met by adding lime or limestone. Okay. So sandy soils need calcium so that we must add lime and limestone. The presence of CO2 dissolved in the soil water promotes solubility of carbonate of lime in soil, ensuring quick carbonate. Okay. CO2, if you increase the CO2 concentration in the soil, which helps in calcium absorption of the plant. Okay, physiological roles. What are the physiological? It is important constituent of middle lamella in the cell wall. Okay. Lamella in the cell wall is essential for formation of cell membrane. It also helps to stabilize the structure of chromosomes. Okay, structure of chromosomes is stabilized. It is concerned with the growing root epicels. This is important function of physiological role of calcium is growing root epicels. It is essential for fat and carbohydrate metabolism, binding of nucleic acids with proteins. It is also essential in the contraction of metal toxicity. Okay, when the any metals like iron toxicity occurs, mean it can suppress it. Okay, immobile in the plant tissue, so it's deficiency occurs on anger leaves. Calcium, ammonium nitrate are important fertilizer, as I told. Okay, which is a or super phosphate or gypsum is supplied in deficient soil. In Indian soil, calcium not a serious problem. Okay, what are the what happened if deficiency is occurred? Cotton, you see, as in cotton, paddy, sugarcane, maize, groundnut, sunflower, these are the deficiencies. Whitish color will be turned and tips will die back. Okay. There is no important this what you know, physiological disorders of calcium. Okay, these are some deficiencies in sorghum. See, tips will be burn out, that is necrosis of tips, root shoot tips is important for to be noted. Okay, see, one of the important disorder is blossom and root. Okay, cracking of fruits, okay, are the two important disorders of calcium deficiency. Blossom and root and fruit cracking. Okay, very 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 important disorders of calcium is only these two. Okay, blossom and root and cracking of fruits. These are the only main disorders to be remembered under the calcium deficiencies. Okay, to decrease it, you must spray calcium ammonium nitrate, can or super phosphate or gypsum to the supply to the soils. Okay, calcium nitrate is advisable. Okay, thank you friends, this is enough. Next video we'll discuss about the micronutrients in detail, in physiological roles and physiological disorders in detail of micronutrients. Okay, thank you friends, bye.